start on the back. Because I feel like we kind of need a moment to start to find that center. Start to move into your breath. And to set an intention or a dedication, if you choose to do so. And then we're just gonna take both arms up overhead, interlacing the fingers, leaving the pointer finger extended. And you're just gonna crawl over towards that top right corner of your mat. You're gonna take the feet to the bottom right corner. You wanna try to keep the body flat against the mat so both shoulders and hips are grounded. And then we're gonna come back through center and just take it on over towards the left. Okay. Fingers and toes dragging those corners of your mat. We're gonna come on back towards center. From here, we're gonna let the arms release. We're gonna plant both feet on the mat. And then go ahead and let both knees drop on over towards the right. So really trying to open up that side body. Then as you inhale, coming back towards center. Exhale, we're gonna take it on over towards the left. And then from here, you're coming back towards center. We're gonna go ahead and draw those knees into the chest. Just taking a quick moment to rock side to side, sort of ironing out any kinks that may or may not have popped up there. And then when you're ready, we're gonna take both feet towards the ceiling, moving into a waterfall. Just starting first by getting that moment of inversion. And with that next breath, we're just gonna drop the left leg, hovering the heel for a quick moment. And then we're gonna switch it. So the left leg rises, right heel lowers and hovers for 5 breaths. With that next breath, right foot meets left foot. And then with your exhale, both heels start to lower down towards the mat for 5 breaths. And then once again, you're gonna draw the knees into the chest. Take a quick second to rock side to side. And then eventually start making your way up to your tabletop. And then from tabletop, starting to move through your calf and your calves. As you inhale, crown the head and tailbone lift. Exhaling to arch up and in. And just moving through some of those. Maybe you incorporate some other movement here. And then that next breath. You're just gonna take the right leg, starting to bring it on up, finding your balance. Some people like to kickstand that left leg out or tuck the toes, whatever it takes to make you feel good here. Because once you feel steady, the right arm's gonna lift. And at first, we're gonna try to keep the hips and the shoulders level. So you're really starting to engage the core. In that next breath, you're gonna start to roll open and stack the shoulders and the hips. So my leg kind of just flared out a little bit back there. So if you need to flare the left leg out to keep steady, feel free to do so. And in that fifth breath, we're going to do 5 oblique crunches. As you exhale, elbow meets knee, coming long. Elbow's going to meet knee again for 2, 3, 4, and last one, 5. From here, we're going to come long. We're going to bend the back knee and see if you can't reach back and grab the outside of the right foot and just kind of kick out behind you. Nice. And that next breath, we're going to step the right foot towards the front of your mat, bringing maybe both hands, like the hands framing the feet. You're just going to pull forward through that right knee. Starting to get a stretch through the front of the left hip flexor. And then as you exhale, pressing back into your half splits. In that, as you're in the next breath, starting to come forward, hands plant, you're gonna go ahead and tuck the left toes, right foot steps back and you're in your plank. And with that next exhale, the knees are gonna come back to the mat, finding your tabletop, moving through cat-cow, whatever free form movement that you need here. So that we can get to the left side. And that next breath, the left leg extends out behind you. Going ahead and adjusting the right leg however you need, knowing where we're going. When you're ready, the right arm reaches, and we're starting first by trying to keep the hips and the shoulders parallel to the mat. And then opening out, stacking hips and shoulders. In that next breath, we're gonna start to move through those crunches. So elbow meets knee, coming long. 2, 3, 4, and last one, 5. After that fifth one, we're gonna bend that back right knee, see if you can't take, I mean the back left knee, see if you can't take the right, the left arm, grab the outside of that foot. I'm just gonna kick out into a half bow, nice. And in that next breath, we're gonna take this left foot, step it to the inside of the hands at the top of your mat, and start to pull forward through that left knee to get the stretch through the right hip flexor in the front. And then you're taking it back into your half Hanuman for your splits prep. And then starting to rock back forward. We're gonna plant those hands, tuck the right toes. Left toes go back to meet right. You've got 5 breaths in your high plank. And with that next exhale, you're gonna take it down to your forearms into a low plank. In that next breath, we're just gonna drop the knees, untuck the toes, press back into a quick child's pose. And then from child's pose, you're coming back up into your tabletop, the toes tuck, knees hover about 3 inches off of your mat in your hover tabletop. And then exhaling on back to your down dog.
And if you need to pedal the heels out here, feel free to do so.
If you're already ready to be still, knowing that's always an option. And then that next breath, we're just gonna make our way up to the hands. Walking, hopping, tiptoeing, whatever feels good in your body today. And inhaling into your flat back. Exhaling to find a fold. Maybe you want a ragdoll. Maybe you're already ready to take a slightly deeper fold. And that next breath, inhaling, arms are going to come up overhead. Exhaling, hands come into heart center. We're going to start to move through two sun A's. So as the arms rise, they're coming up. Exhaling to fold to your mat. Inhaling, flat back. Exhaling to move through plank and chaturanga. Inhaling into your up dog or cobra. Exhaling back to down dog. And then your next breath, you're gonna take it back to the hands, whatever way you like. Finding your flat back, exhaling back into a fold. With your next breath, arms come up overhead. Exhale, hands come into heart center. Move through a second one, so the arms are rising. Exhaling into your fold. Inhaling into your flat back. Exhaling right back through your favorite version of plank and chaturanga. Maybe you have extra push-ups. Maybe you spend some extra thrust in your up dog. In that fifth breath, we're taking it right back to the top of the mat in whatever way you like. Finding your flat back, exhaling into your fold. As you inhale, arms come up overhead. We're gonna try to glue the arms to the ears as you sit back into your chair. Exhaling on into your fold. Inhaling into a flat back. And then moving through your vinyasa. So plank, chaturanga, up dog or cobra, back to down dog. And in that fifth breath, we're taking it right back towards the top of your mat. Finding a flat back, moving into your fold. As you inhale, arms come up overhead. As you exhale, you're gonna sit back into your chair. And then from here, the right arm swings back. So you're starting to twist open over your right side. In your fifth breath, you're gonna see if you can't take that right foot. Step it back into a twisted crescent variation. Nice. In your fifth breath, we're just going to drop back, keeping that asymmetry. Nice. And in your next breath, we're just going to bring the right arm forward, coming all the way into your crescent. You might need to readjust your feet, whatever it takes. Just feel good here. And we're gonna do 5 speed skaters. So as you inhale, the right knee comes up, arms go back. Exhaling to step back into your crescent. So 2, inhaling up. Exhaling to step back. 3. Going right back, 4, and 5. After that fifth one, we're gonna land in crescent. Let the hands come in together into heart center. And take this right knee across the body towards the left. So you're finding a revolved variation of a side angle, but with crescent feet. And in that next breath, we're gonna keep the legs just like they are, but we're gonna let the right hand come to the mat inside that left foot. Left arm reaches up as you twist back and find your side plank. In that next breath, we're gonna find our regular plank, move through our vinyasa, or skip it, whatever's working for you. So we can get into the left side. And in that next breath, you're gonna bend the knees, taking the hips way back towards the heels, froggy hopping up to the hands. Inhaling into your flat back. Exhaling into your fold. As you inhale, arms are gonna come up overhead. Exhaling, hands are coming into heart center. You're gonna sit back in your chair and then start to twist the arms open towards the left. Fifth breath, we're gonna try to step back into that crescent stance. Nice. And then drop on back into your peaceful variation here. From peaceful, we're coming into our crescents. We've got our five speed skaters. So that right knee, when the right knee comes up, yes, we're gonna take the arms back, stepping back. For me, it helps to move through these slowly. I just keep better balance. Some people like that speed. Whatever's working for you. Four. And five. And from that fifth breath, we're stepping back. Finding your crescent, bringing hands into heart center, and then finding your twist. So the right elbow is going to cross the body towards the left knee. And finishing off with our side plank. So the right hand's coming to the inside of that left foot. We're going to start to twist on the back of the right foot, shooting the left leg back, finding your side plank. Back to center and moving through your vinyasa. Taking it back to down dog. Maybe you take a child's pose. We've got five breaths here. And when you're ready, we're gonna take it to the top of the mat, walking or hopping, whatever your favorite is. Finding your flat back. Exhaling into your fold. As you inhale, arms come up overhead. Exhale, hands are coming into heart center. We're gonna sit back into our chair. And then you're gonna see if you can't hover that right, bend the right knee, so you're just taking your chair on the left. So the right foot might be hovering, or you might even bend the knee, just whatever helps you feel more stable. And then once again, we're gonna step on back. So we're in a, we've got our left knee forward, right foot's back. We're gonna go ahead and twist open, taking the right hand to the inside of the left foot, just reaching towards the ceiling. And And so as we move into our next posture, we're going to take heel toe the left foot out just a little bit, so you've got a wider base, to bring the left hand to the inside of the left foot. And then from here, we're going to drop that back heel open, starting to reach up. So you're kind of in a Skandasana variation here. Kind of like a really low side angle. But this is a pretty good prep for this weird side angle that we're going to try to play with later. I don't know if it's possible. Jen's let us through it once. We'll see if we can get through it again today. And then from here, you're going to come back towards center. That's going to go ahead and make you come back up onto the toes of the right foot. We're going to drop that knee. Let the toes come long. Maybe you stay here in your lizard. Maybe you come down to the forearms. The nice part about taking lizard with the back knee drop is you can pull forward through that left knee and get a bigger stretch through the right hip. And then from here, we're gonna come back up onto the hands. If you rocked forward on that knee, we're gonna come back. You're gonna go ahead and rotate the left toes towards the top left corner of the mat. Then the toes and the foot and the knee drop open. The left hand comes to the inside of the knee, and you're gonna start first by twisting and looking back over that shoulder. In your fifth breath, you're going to kick this back left leg up. You might stay here. You might be able to reach back and grab that back leg that you kicked up and pull it. Oh, it's our right leg. Yeah, pull it into the body. Still trying to keep that gaze behind you. And in that fifth breath, we're coming back towards center. We've already got the hands planted and grounded. We're just gonna tuck the right toes. Really get strong in the hands, get strong in those toes, engage the core, and then shoot that left leg back so that you're in a high plank. And move through your vinyasa because we're going to the left side, or the other side. Inhaling up, taking it back to your down dog. With that next breath, whatever your favorite method of getting to the top of your mat is, inhaling flat back, exhaling back into your pull. As you inhale, arms come up overhead. Exhale, hands come into heart center. You're going to sit back in your chair. When you find your chair, you're deciding whether or not you just want to stay here, hover the left foot, or even bend the knee. Whatever just feels more stable and good for you. And in your fifth breath, we're stepping that left foot back, coming back into that kind of crescent lunge variation. Nice. Okay, so from here, we took the left hand comes to the inside of the right foot. You're twisting open towards the right. In our fifth breath, we're taking this right hand to the mat, inside of the right leg if you can. The left foot in the back, so kind of rolls open. You're rolling the left arm open. So we're already, again, once again, setting up to see if we can't find that weird little balance in a side angle or a side plank. Then from here, hands are coming back towards center. We're popping back up on the back toes. You might need to heel toe the right foot out just a little bit to get that wider stance for your hips as we drop the back knee. The toes come long. Maybe you stay here in your lizard. Maybe you come down to the forearms. Maybe once again, you pull forward through that right knee. So from here, we're moving back up onto the hands. We're gonna move into that twist. So the right toes are gonna bend open, so they're pointed towards the top right corner of your mat. The knee and the foot and the toes all drop open, going the same direction. And then you're just coming up and taking the right hand to the inside of the right knee as you twist and look behind you at the back toes if possible. Maybe you're just looking over the shoulder. Maybe you're looking out to the side. And we're gonna find that big quad stretch here. So the left knee bends in the back. Maybe you stay here. Maybe you can reach back with the right hand. Pull the left knee into the body. And in our next breath, we're coming back forward, getting rid of all our twists and binds. We've got the hands really planted firm. We're gonna plug back into those left toes so the right foot can meet them back there in a plank and move through a vinyasa, so chaturanga, up dog cobra. And we're gonna take it back to a child's pose so we can kind of thread the needle, open up the shoulders, let them release a little bit. Right arm lifts, threads underneath the left arm. Maybe you stay here. Maybe you take that bounded variation that we did yesterday. And then we're gonna come back towards center. The left arm comes up, threads underneath right. Maybe you stay here. Maybe you take that half bind. And then from here, we're going back towards center. We're gonna take it up to a cat-cow. Just move to release the back in any more ways that you need to, maybe hip circles, maybe not. And then from here, we're gonna take it to a down dog and move through one more flow before we hit the mat for some core inversions and back bends. So whenever you're ready, finding your down dog. And then you're just gonna make your way back to the hands. Inhaling into your flat back, exhaling into your fold. As you inhale, arms come up overhead. Exhale, hands come back to heart center as we move through a chair. Folding over the toes, inhaling into your flat back. We're gonna vinyasa so that we can get to the right side. The right leg lifts. If you want to open that hip, circle it. Anything you like to feel nice here, feel free to do so. And in your fifth breath, the right foot takes it to the front of the mat. We're gonna start in a crescent, so plugging in those back toes, starting to lift up. Back heel comes in as you twist open into your warrior two. We're gonna take the hands to the back, rolling the shoulders open, clasping them, coming into a humble warrior stance. Instead of doing like that speed skater we did, we're gonna do waterfall warriors as you inhale, starting to come up. Exhaling to fold. Inhaling, sweep your way back up. Exhaling as you fold. Two. Three. Four. And And on our fifth one, we're gonna find ourselves holding our humble for 5 breaths. Starting to try to really draw the hands away from the body. Inhaling, we're gonna find our way back up. Release the arms out wide to a warrior two, and then drop on back into your reverse. From your reverse, as you exhale, you're gonna start to come down, letting the right hand settle to the inside of the right foot. If you need to let the left hand come to the mat to really try to get there, what's gonna really help is if you can line up the arm and the shin together. So this is that really kind of weird side plank that Jen took us into where you're like in the splits. So there are a couple places that you can stay here. You might just start first by starting to feel what it's like to wrap this right leg around that arm. If you feel good there, you can kind of start to shift forward on that back foot, coming more to the side of it, like a side plank, which is gonna cause you to move forward on the arm. You might find that you're able to take that foot that you hooked around the arm up. This is gonna help build strength. You might find that you're able to, ouch, kick it out. We can play here for a little bit. It's kind of a weird one. Again, there's so many different places to stop. Sort of figuring out where you are and starting to learn how to hook that leg around the shoulder. Starting to find balance points. Again, stopping anywhere along the way. Nice. And whenever you're done playing, there's not really a super graceful way to get back out of a weird side plank like that, other than just stepping the feet back and finding a plank, moving through our chaturanga so that we can wrap all that up on the left. It might feel nice to stay in your up dog a little bit longer and kind of rock the shoulders back. Sort of releases that hip a little bit. And then take it back to your down dog. And the left leg comes up, maybe you stack the hips, bend the knee, just kind of circle things out. And from that fifth breath, we are finding our crescent. So the left foot comes forward, coming onto the back heels, just starting to lift up. Dropping into your warrior two, that back heel spins out, arms start to level. Hands are going to clasp behind the back. We've got those 5 moving humble warriors. So inhaling for some length, exhaling to full, inhaling for 2, exhaling. Four. And on this fifth one, when we reach the bottom, we're gonna hold it for 5 breaths. As you inhale to come up, we're gonna find our warrior twos to help us make our way back into your reverse. And as you exhale, we're gonna start to come out wide, taking the left hand to the inside of the left foot, trying to line up arm and shin if possible, so it might require you to step the right foot back for a wider stance. You might just stay here, starting to feel what that is, starting to really build some more flexibility in the hips. You might be able to kind of shimmy the arm back and the left foot around, getting that foot in front. If that feels okay, it's kind of nice to shift the weight forward and see if you can't just hover the left foot. If you feel okay there, you kind of start to roll and stack the shoulders and the hips. The farther up towards the shoulder that you can get the leg to hook, the easier it's going to be to start to roll open. And then eventually, take that left foot out. We've got about 5 more breaths. You can play around with any place stopping here. In that 5th breath, we're just gonna bring the right hand back to the mat. Try to somehow unhook that left leg, stepping back to your plank, moving through whatever vinyasa you want to here. And then from that vinyasa, we're gonna take it right back to your child's pose for just a second, but keeping the fingertips tinted so the hands are really active. So in this child's pose, we're gonna shift to make sure the knees are together. You're going to now take the hands overhead, interlacing them with the pointer finger extended. Activate the arms until they're glued into the ears. Really start to engage the core. Try to draw the sitting bones back towards the heels. And you wanna try to roll up, keeping the heels connected to the hips and the arms connected to the ears. It requires a lot of core. Then when you get, nice. And when you make your way towards the top, let the arms come down. We're gonna take the left hand to the outside of the right thigh. Kind of tint that right hand behind you and twist over the knees. With your next exhale, taking it to the opposite side. And then as you're ready, we're coming back front. Legs spin around in front of you. You're gonna start to flex the feet, flexing them so much so that the heels come off the mat. Calves engage, knees engage, quads engage. Starting to draw the navel towards the spine and then rolling the shoulders down your back. Trying to plant the hands next to the hip, slightly tucking the chin so the entire body is in a moment of contraction into your staff pose. Inhaling, arms come up. Exhaling, folding towards the toes. Inhaling to make your way back up. We're gonna bring the soles of the feet together. Inhaling to find a flat back and exhaling to fold forward, pulling through the chin so you're keeping that flat spine. In your 5th breath, we're gonna inhale back up. We're gonna rotate the knees up towards each other. Start to grab behind the thighs, trying to pull the heart forward as you rock back. Finding your balance point, then feet come up. The toes might stay pointed or flexed. You might stay here in your boat. You might release the arms. you might extend the legs. In your fifth breath, you're gonna bend the knees, drawing them as close into the chest as you can. Five breaths, you're going back out to boat. Last five breaths, you're drawing those knees back in, trying to keep the legs up. And then as you're ready, exhaling, let the legs come out long, arms come overhead, finding a second forward fold. Maybe this time you're able to bind the hands around the outside of the feet. Maybe you're able to get just a little bit deeper. Inhaling, we're coming back up. We're gonna leave that left leg long. Right sole of the foot's gonna find your inner thigh. Inhaling as the arms come up. Exhaling as you fold towards the toes into your Janu A. Inhale, we're gonna come back up. We're gonna make our way into a Janu C. We normally don't do this posture because it's super weird. But since we're all probably not walking and stuff as much, we probably need to get into our toes and ankles a little bit more. So the left leg stays where it is, as does the right leg, except you're gonna take that right leg out a tiny bit. I like to, from here, take my left hand and grab the outside of my right heel. That way I have the right hand to take my foot and help point the toes towards my mat. So I come into this like really weird thing on my foot. Your toes are grounded. If you can't get your toes to the mat, you're just gonna work on pressing with the left hand, the heel forward, and with the right hand, try and guide the toes down towards the mat. If your toes did come to the mat, you might push yourself forward on the hips to come higher up onto the toes. So you're kind of got a twisting opening happening in the knee, crazy stuff happening in the ankle, and then opening the toes. If you feel comfortable wherever you are, fold and stop where your knees tell you to.
Sweet John, you see, yes. Big brother has got excited.
When you come inhaling back out of your John, you see, kind of shaking that leg out, letting it do whatever it needs to do. And we're going to get into the left side, so the left foot comes to the inner thigh. Inhaling, the arms are coming up overhead. Exhaling to fold towards the toes. Inhaling back up, and we're gonna move back into that Janu C. So you've got the left foot, the left hand's kind of grabbing the back of the left heel, pushing it forward. The right hand is coming to the front, the left toes, kind of helping guide them down to the mat. You might just stay there working on opening the ankles and the toes and the feet. If your toes found the mat, you're gonna shift those hips forward, try to get on top of the toes. And wherever you are, starting to fold until where you feel comfortable in your Janu C. And from here, inhaling, we're gonna make our way back up. We'll leave that right foot extended. We're gonna take the left foot and just step it across the right knee. Left hand plants behind that left hip. Inhaling, the right arm comes up. As you exhale, you're gonna hook it to the outside of the left knee. Inhaling to find some length. exhaling, just start to twist over the back. If you are still trying to build flexibility in the shoulders, go towards that reachy C or any of those other binds that we played with yesterday, you can still open that right arm and reach for the toes on the outside of your knee. And you can always take a half bind with that left arm. When you're ready, we're gonna come out of our little twist. We're gonna maybe grab a counter twist and then switch the legs. So the left leg comes long, right leg steps across, the hand plants behind that hip. Inhaling as the left arm comes up. Exhaling as you start to move into that twist. Inhaling to find some length through the crown of the head. Exhaling, maybe you twist a little deeper. If you want to extend that left arm, see if you can grab the right toes. You want your half bind. And after that, we're coming right back forward. We're gonna take the legs out wide, inhaling for some length, exhaling to crawl out forward. Starting first by just tinting those fingertips. If you need to roll any flesh out from the sitting bones, feel free to do so. But inhaling to find length, exhaling to allow those tinted fingertips to help you move a little bit more slowly into the inner thighs. And as you inhale, arms are gonna come up overhead. We're gonna go ahead and start exhaling before we even begin to fold. So taking your favorite variation here. You might like arms forward. You might wanna bind on the feet. Inhale, we're gonna come back up. We're gonna let the legs come in together. We're gonna start to make our way onto the back. So from here, we are going to start moving into our back bending and inverting. We're going to do, we've got time to do three back bends today. So we're gonna do three back bends, yogi's choice. I will cue probably a bridge, a wheel, and a bridge. If you want to do wheel, bridge, wheel, whatever. If you only want to do two, if you don't want to do them at all. We're going to be here for about 30-ish breaths. So whatever you feel like you want to do. If you are going into bridge for the first set, our heels come in close to the sitting bones, aligned with them. Palms are down by your side, pressed into the mat. Inhaling at the bottom, exhaling as you press through the feet to lift the hips. Arms roll beneath you, hands clasp beneath you. And then before you start to make any fancy fun modifications in your bridge, you're gonna check in with those knees. Just making sure that they're not flailing open, they're stacked on top of the ankles. Once you've got that, maybe you like coming onto the tiptoes. Maybe you like lifting one leg, the other leg. Maybe you like to bend the elbows, letting them become somewhat of a support, like a block. So you're just going for eight breaths here. We've probably already gone through about eight, to be quite honest. So the heels start to lower. Finding a counter pose. So maybe you're windshield wipering the knees side to side. Maybe you're a happy baby. Just anything to get the back flat for a second. And if you're headed into wheel, the heels come in close to the sitting bones, aligned with them. Fingers are pointed back towards, are up near the ears, pointed back towards the shoulders. Inhaling at the bottom, exhaling to lift. And in wheel, we are trying to think about similar concepts. Stacking elbows on top of shoulders, knees on top of ankles, so kind of rolling and adjusting how you need to. As always, eight breaths. after you've got your eight breaths, finding your counter pose. And then heading back into your last and final back bend. I'm cueing a bridge. Yours might be something different. Maybe you have fun props at home. I know we've got a couple of those inversion stools, but the yoga wheels are pretty great for back bends. You have one of those. But if you're going into a bridge, heels are in tight or aligned with the sitting bones. Palms are down by the side, pressed into the mat. You're gonna press into those feet as you lift. Roll the shoulders underneath the body. Check into the knees and then play with whatever modification or adjustment you want for eight breaths. With that next breath starting to lower down, finding your favorite counter pose. And so from here, we're just gonna let the arms come out wide, and you're gonna let both sets of, you're gonna plant both feet on the ground, both sets of knees drop towards the right. We're thinking about trying to stack the knees while keeping the left shoulder blade grounded. So you're sort of thinking about pulling forward through that left knee while rolling the left shoulder down towards your mat. You should find a twist. Inhaling back towards center. Exhaling on over towards the left. And same thing, we're thinking about trying to keep the knees stacked, the shoulders grounded. You can always use your left hand to assist by pulling that like hip or thigh or whatever forward. And then coming back towards center. So from here, we're gonna move into your inversions. And again, it's kind of open play here. Maybe you're just legs up today. Maybe you're shoulder stand. Maybe you're inverting all the way into some sort of headstand, handstand, shoulder stand, whatever. But we've got about 10 to 15-ish breaths here. I'm going to do a shoulder stand today. If you feel like following along, that's totally up to you. But we're gonna sit for a shoulder stand. We're gonna start first by taking the heel of the feet towards the ceiling and then rocking back, letting the hands come to the low back. And then from there, just starting to allow, trying to settle the weight back in the elbows and not in the neck. Keeping the core engaged and everything tight is gonna help you find a straighter line and feel lighter here. And as you exhale, we're going to take it back to a plow. From plow, you might keep the toes tucked or long, and the hands might stay at the low back, or they might come long to your mat, yogi's choice. In that next breath, if you release the hands, they're coming back to the low back as you revisit your shoulder stand for five more breaths. And then whenever you're ready, we're gonna start to make our way back towards the back. When you find your back, arms are coming out into a T. You're gonna cross the right leg all the way over the left. You might even be able to cross again at the ankles like eagle legs. And then both knees fall over towards the right. Gaze might go long towards the left. And inhale, and we're coming back up. We're gonna switch that twist. The left leg crosses over right, maybe again at the ankles. As you drop towards the left, gaze starts to go towards the right. Then from here, coming back towards center, we're gonna draw the knees into the chest, take a second to rock side to side, and then you're gonna go ahead and take hold of the right knee, let the long knee come long, and the left knee come long, then really start to draw the right knee towards the shoulders. If you find those feet flexed, it's gonna help you stay grounded, but also really kind of pull towards that shoulder. And as you exhale, switch on over towards the left, so finding that wind-removing pose on the opposite side. And then from here, we're going to draw the right knee back up to meet the left. Take a moment to just rock out anything going on in the back. Ready towards Shavasana. So some people like to just kind of rock it out and then find their rest. Other people like to find that moment of compression. Maybe you need some more movements to round out your practice. And then starting to make your way towards that final Shavasana. In those next couple of breaths, we'll start letting the small movements return to the body, starting in fingers and toes, moving into wrists and ankles. And then as you're ready, starting to make your way back to seated. Thank you. And as you inhale, arms are going to come on up overhead. Exhale, hands come into heart center. Thank you guys so much for playing again today. I hope you guys have an awesome Thursday. Super pretty outside. Maybe catch some sun. Namaste.